Hello, and welcome. I'm Zeinder, and here we are once again playing modded Minecraft. A bit early in the morning, so I apologize if I sound like I have a bit of a morning voice. And I have a couple things planned for today. I see you, skeleton. You may notice the little thing I built out there isn't there, and I've got some of the quite clear glass in here. I've just got two water streams out there that just drop them down here. It works better. For some reason, they're AI, because of zombie awareness, pretty much ignores the attractor obelisk if I'm anywhere nearby. So, actually a slight waste. Only a slight waste. Conversely, there is... I've got my broken spawner of Enderman. And... well, also, I kind of used that system to make a few diamonds, so we're good there. I've made some reinforced silver lockers, so we'll start with a locker. It's pretty simple. It's basically just a vertical double chest. That's all lockers really are, chests, and if you stack them right, they become vertical double chests, basically. So, although I have them upgraded with silver, because I have pretty much no use for silver, so, this is what it takes. It takes a silver block and four silver ingots to upgrade one of these. It also takes three logs, which obviously I've got more than enough of. Stupid mob drops that I don't want. I could just put those in the void chest, but it's probably kind of full. I've been using apples because that's all I really have, but there's plenty of wood in here. This system over here is processing more cellulose than it knows what to do with, still. Because I put, like, 10 stacks of logs in there. And then this double silver-reinforced locker is completely full. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 by 6. So... like three chests worth, and then this one's almost full as well, so I got a lot. I had filled up my crate, which is part of the reason why I did that. I made some Eulorium... Spider, do you mind? I made some Eulorium. I could just put those in there. Via this. Now, I got a bunch of blaze rods, I just farmed some blazes. Because I need to make some plutonium. Two of it, actually. Whatever. I'll do it this way. I'm just gonna do that. That's actually more than I need, but the whole reason I did that was to reset the stack size. Well, more of remerge the stacks. Okay, now that little inventory's bug's gone away. Put that blaze powder up there. And I'll need to smelt the plutonium. Smelt, please. So that'll give us plutonium ingots. So that gets us going there. I don't really care about this. I do care about not having any sand after I do this, but... if you take Eulorium and mix it with sand, you get cyanide. I believe that's new of the 1710 version, but I might be wrong. It could be in 164, just in a later patch than I used. I see an experience orb. Oh, there we go. Speaking of experience orbs, I don't remember if I showed the obelisk, but it's basically a stationary version of it, but... I looked in the config, and apparently this thing supports, basically, the only way I can describe it is max float value experience levels, so like 24 billion experience, or 2 billion experience, something like that. 2 billion levels, I should say, not experience. Although maybe it is levels. That's still a lot of levels. Now, I've also... made my two vibrant crystals. The logic controller made that before. Got the zombie head in there, so... powered spawner. Now, because I've got this, I've got... I can retrieve 10 levels at a time. Wow, I almost have another 30 levels in there. And you know what? Before we do this, I want to test something. There is the steam hammer. A block of iron, two iron, and two brass. I mean, it's probably going to be useful in other cases if it doesn't work here, but I want to know if it works here. I have an extra pipe, right? Yes. Okay, so. Anvil, please come with me. I've moved it down in, which. Oh, I'm actually gonna. Oh no. Yeah, no. Maybe. Maybe. Pull you off. Pull you off. Leaking steam. Yes, I'm aware. Okay, good, it connected. I'm wondering if I can get away with not using. It's got a kind of funky hitbox. If I do this and this. Okay, that's what I thought. Things like that will not work in there. I'm assuming that. I mean, that's. Eh, I can work with that. So now we have a powered spawner Enderman. My question is, how much. Holy crap! Endermen are expensive! Well, get what you pay for. On the topic of expensive, yes, I'm aware I just picked up those things I threw down there. We can't really power that at the moment. Well, I could probably power it in bursts, but. I'm gonna hook this back up because, you know what? 20 RF attack doesn't mean crap. And I'll just take you out, even though that thing's probably going to burn forever. And put you in there. So, I made the powered spawner. Now, obviously, I want to upgrade my power system. That's part of the reason why I made the plutonium. And it's also why I have the cyanite. Three stacks. If it's overkill, then it's overkill. Otherwise, whatever. There goes basically all my coal. So, I need three diamonds. Four diamonds. Four diamonds. And we're going to look at turbine. And I'm gonna need one of these, for sure. Oh, right. I'm gonna need a ton of iron as well. All right, nether quartz. Hopefully that's enough. So we need one, two, three. I should probably make two of these. So four, five. Five sets of these right off. What am I missing? Oh, graphite. So, one, two, three, four, five. Turbine controller. That's what the plutonium was needed for. Turbine power port. I'm going to need some redstone. There we go. Stack should be good. I'm only going to need one power port, most likely. I'm not going to be generating enough RF per tick at first to really require it. And then, even still. I could just slap the capacitor bank up against it, and that would at least handle 5,000. So, we're good there. I don't really want to use up my buckets, but I guess I will. I'm gonna need some cobble. Cobble, 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 cobble. So, what was I doing? Pistons. One, two. Oh, my buckets have water in them, so I guess I'll make two new buckets. And go. Okay. Now I need to make two rotor bearings. One, two. I'm gonna actually need to make more than that, but. I'm not gonna be making a full-size boiler, so I do have the extra materials in here. Low pressure boilers are 2 iron plates, which 4 iron plates is 4 ingots. So I made enough fire charges, furnaces, and boiler tanks for a full size low pressure boiler because low pressure is more efficient. Like, just in general, like, I'd be better off making 2 full-size low-pressure boilers than 1 high-pressure boiler because I will get more power per energy, roughly. So I suppose on that's a good number of that. I guess it's now time to move over to the boiler side of things. We're gonna make it takes 7 bricks, fire charge, and a furnace. So we're making 4 solid fuel boilers. I'm probably gonna make like the smallest size boiler I can possibly comprehend, and I'm gonna put it over here because I have expanded things and I've cut a hole in there too wide, so we don't need to worry about that at the moment. We'll pick you up. How do I want to do this? Where? I'll cut that. Make things slightly visible. Okay, so here and here. Actually, I'm gonna want to do it here and here. And then, bam, bam, bam. And I'll probably just slap it right up against the wall for now. You know what? Let's. I put the shovel upgrade on this. If that didn't show that and give that away. Got 2 things of water already, which is good. You're not running anymore. Deal with it. Could just probably make another reservoir, but can't be bothered. Okay, so reservoir, reservoir. You're in there. Yeah, well, I'll just cover it up the whole way. No. Why did that happen? Weird. Nothing it can. Oh, it took out a torch. Okay, so. Oh, wrench you. 2, 3, 4. And I believe this can go 3 high. I know it has to be a minimum of at least 2. There we go. I think that's gonna be roughly 240 a tick. I don't know what material I should use. I could probably make 9 steel without even thinking about it. 9 steel blocks. I think steel blocks are the highest, simplest thing I can get right now. As far as I'm aware, nickel's not even an available option. And I'm probably generating 240 steam per tick. So we're gonna go with 4 rotor bearings. The easiest way to get to that is just go back through here. Not rotor bearings, but rotor shafts. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then for 3 of those, we need these. Very good. That gets us 12. And then we need more turbine housings. That's not going to be enough, for sure. Iron's my limiting factor in this case, but that's okay. I'm gonna butt it right up against there. So this needs to be 5. This needs to be 5. Yeah, not even close. But I expected that. I completely expected that. Oh, I can't actually see my timer. Oh, well, I guess we're gonna go until the boiler's done. My timer, as I call it, is just a thing on OBS, because that's what I record with. Oh. What am I missing? Graphite. Yeah. Out of iron again. I don't think this is going to be enough in the slightest. In fact, I'm about 95% sure it's not. I'm going to put the power port here. And the rotor bearing goes in... Well, technically I could reverse the thing, but I want... Whoops. I want it right here. And that's all that's going to be on this side, so I can actually finish this off. Here we go. Ow. Two fluid ports. So those will go there, and I'm going to put the controller here. Now it's just a matter of burning through the rest of my iron, really. I might have to settle with something stupid like copper. Just because I'm not going to have enough iron to make steel blocks. I have more iron in the mining area, but I'd have to go get it and process it, which I might end needing to do eventually anyway. Why did I type steam? The word I'm looking for is turbine. That's not going to be enough. I'm actually going to need to go get some iron to process. Unless by some mere... Nope, six isn't going to do it. Oh, I should probably put in these. So we'll start with 1, 2, 3. For simplicity, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So this can support up to 300 millibuckets of steam per tick. I believe gold is the best, but I don't have anywhere near enough blocks for that. I think bronze might actually do better than copper, but at this point, I'm looking to just get more power than I'm generating, and I'm not really too concerned about how efficient I am with said power. And I keep on thinking it's 9 blocks every single time I do that for some reason. Wait. I know my limiting factor was, quartz. I need one more set, which means I'm going to have leftovers, but that's almost always a thing. Yeah, leftovers. But that is that thing. I'm going to use... Right, you can't access lockers from the back. I'm going to use item conduits since I have quite a few of them. No, that is not where you're supposed to be at all. You are filled with water, very good. I don't actually like the idea of two connections. Don't argue with me. You will insert, you'll extract, and you will extract. So, this is going to take a while to spin up. That's the only major downside at this exact second. I'm not sure how much power it's going to be able to handle. Probably higher than I have cable-wise. You know what? You're my buffer block because... Well, not buffer, but... You're the block I put in to make sure I could connect, but I'm not going to be generating more than 5,000, so you will go there, and then I'll have to probably make more conductive iron for those connections. Maybe I can get away with it. Ugh. Gonna be a really tight fit. I have two left. That is not enough. I need two more. I mean, I can just kind of salvage it from this power setup. Because I can actually salvage the whole power setup. Yeah. Yeah. And then for the temporary moment, we'll put this, this, and this back down. And that leaves the situation of fucking those up. I am out of stone kinesis pipes. Four. Oops. So used to my redstone being a little higher. Gonna get 16 out of that. Graphite, you can go back in there. Iron, you can go in there. Cyanite, you can go in there. Quartz, go where you belong. So I'm gonna have to expand this out at some point, but that's not gonna happen right now. You know what? I'm curious. And now's the best time to try my curiosity. If I plug you into here, and I go down here and set you to insert, like thus, and then I sit you down back over here. By the way, this is an iron kinesis pipe. It's used for limiting. Is that actually working? No way. That is amazing, to say the least. Except I know that I'm drawing more power. Oh. Maybe I'm not. I used all the cellulose. Okay, I can live with that. I can also live with that. This is an acceptable setup. I can... So Ender.io won't accept from BuildCraft, but BuildCraft will accept from Ender.io. Wait. Well, no, because the pipes just don't even connect at all. So... Yeah. You're outputting. You are almost at 100, but that's not going to mean much because you won't output at full speed till you get completely maxed. I'm not sure how big of a boiler this is. Actually, I can math it out. There is 12 tanks on there, so it's 120 per tank? No. Yes. No? I think it's 120. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds right. 120. But just as an experiment, I'm going to set this to 119, because then if I see buildup, I know that there's more to be used. 120 might actually be accurate for the copper, but in terms of power output, it's going to be kind of crap, to say the least. So that will spin up and generate power, plus I've got the three generators running in the meantime. Kind of a sloppy setup, but what are you gonna do? I know that... What? These are non-spawnable blocks? I don't believe you. Ow. Okay. I'm gonna call that working. I may have to do some fine tweaking eventually. Hey, zombies. Where are you going? You're trying to find where I injured myself at. Whoa, where'd you come from, Torch? So it's raining now. So basically, this is my experience farm. Oh, and a piece of iron. That's always good. Considering I just burnt through a metric ton of iron. But I have at least a stack of ore I haven't even used yet, so... I actually think that if I get punched by a zombie, and it causes the sort of, like, scent awareness effect, it makes it more efficient because then more zombies come? At least that's the theory. Reorganize you... More zombie heads. I have almost a full stack of zombie heads. You know, I was gonna make more stone kinesis pipes, and then I didn't, because it turned out that I didn't need to. Just realized that, because I was like, why do I have all this extra redstone and stuff in my inventory? And you can go in there, I'm not gonna worry about filling that in. Nether brick fences. Do I decompose you? Nah. Not at the moment. Oops. I bet you they're in here. No, well, there is nether bricks in there, but meh. And fluid pipe, because this steam system is not running anymore at the moment. Oh, should probably dump my XP. Yeah, up to 32 levels in there. You're overflowing in steam. Why is this? Because you're not using steam, because I never activated the turbine. You're draining. Good. Good. Oh, look at that! 40 RF a tick! And it's empty. But the rotor is still spinning up. Honestly, if I can get at least the 240 out of it, that'll please me for the moment. It is going up slowly. You're at 168 degrees Celsius. You know what I can do? I can kind of break the system. If I disengage the coils, it'll spin up quicker, and then once it's up to a higher value, I can then turn it off. Yes, you are actually set to an input. Thank you for being intelligent on that aspect. I'm waiting to see if it actually gets close to 900. And that's probably going to lose a ton once I press the button, because it's not receiving steam at its maximum speed. Oops, that's not what I wanted to adjust. Engage! Yeah, I figured that. You're actually going to go down, and the amount of RF per tick you're generating is actually kind of crap. But that's... Oh no, is it going down or is it going up? It's sort of halfway stabilized there. It'll get more efficient the closer to 900 RPM, but I think the best that I can expect from copper is actually really bad. All in all, once this gets completely to the maximum, once it gets up to 500 heat, because this is a low-pressure boiler, it'll be running at maximum efficiency, and these fuels will actually last either their burn time or slightly less. I think it'll actually run higher than its burn time, so that should be okay. And also our steam output will get more efficient. I like how we're stabilized at almost exactly 90 RF a tick. So we're gaining here, so I'm gonna try and choke the system out, and I'm going to drop some more wood. Oh, what? What did I do there? That was weird. Yeah, that'll do. Now, the unfortunate truth of the situation is that this void chest is not fast enough. But, figure that out eventually. We're either at 30 minutes or getting close to 40. Wait, is it still nighttime? Can I sleep away the rain? No. Yes. Yes! Okay. Cool. We'll make the rain go away. I'm sort of generating power. It is slowly going up, so... I'm just going to leave this at 120, because if I'm right, that's how much should be generating. I'll have to fine-tweak this. I do know about the Big Turbine Google Doc. So, Big Reactor's Turbine Google Doc, so I'll have to look into that. This is going to be generating terrible, terrible amounts of power, but I'll look into what other viable materials are, look into what I have available to me at this exact moment, figure out what speeds and whatnot, but I'm going to call this good for now, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day.